So what we're dealing with sometimes is that we are going through a process of unhooking from our connection with that vitally important person who was a source of life in the natural and whose life should have pointed us to the higher and greater life and the greater faithfulness of God and of Jesus. Does that make sense? We're Trinitarians. We believe that Jesus is not just the Son of God. He is God. And so it's interesting if we think about our roles as parents that we are placeholders. We represent and symbolize the love that is even greater, the love of God Almighty for us. The security that we receive from an earthly mother or an earthly father is supposed to be a foretaste, a down payment of the glory and the glorious commitment that our God has for us. No matter how devoted the mother or the father, God is more devoted than they. No matter how spectacular their commitment to us, to what extremes they would go for us, the limitless, boundless sense of love that is in them for us, God's love is greater than their love. And if we really had a revelation of it, we'd understand that God put them in that position so there would come a point in our lives that we would transfer our confidence from them to Him. And for a short time on earth, we would have a connection with Almighty God and a pretty mighty mom or dad. But Ecclesiastes 3 tells us that there is a time to be born and a time to die. And a time for every purpose under heaven. And this good thing called a nurturing mother's love fades away. No mother, no father, no matter how great they were, can ever be as great as God. All of us are flawed. All of us live in the human condition. But there's a special blessing attached for us if we can learn how to honor our mothers and our fathers despite their quirkiness and their flaws. They birthed us into the world. They were assigned to us, and the good ones did the best that they could to help us on our journey. And therefore, we need to give thanks.